And we just tell everybody's business here.
What don't matter? This ain't HIPAA. We ain't got no HIPAA laws on this show, girl. We keeping it real right here. You don't see no Dr. Hager. Woo. I'm just the doctor of love this morning.
Oh, good morning, everybody.
That's the problem. You better check hell this morning.
I'm going to bring it next week.
Come on, it's morning show. Let's roll. Throw your hands up, play my song. Cut back to her. She's going to be going, oh. Pat, I'm gonna need a little more pat on that head, son. I'm making it happen.
Guess who's back? Back again. Shamie's back. Tell a friend.
Good morning, show, because we back in the house today, son.
Good morning.
Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess.
Hey, and let's just go ahead and just get it right off our chest early in the morning. It's good to be back, and we're glad that you're with us. So good morning, Simple Church.
Good morning.
What's up, son? You know, Angie.
What you got, Justin?
Well, I know what you got.
Okay.
Because, you know, we had some guest host while we were in.
We had some guest hosts. We did. Evan, a little Mallory.
Yeah, and Evan was great.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to pause on Mallory.
Let's talk about Mallory for a second.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. She came to me for some advice before.
Angie, hold on a second. What did she come to you for?
She said, I'm so nervous.
She said, I don't think I want to be on the camera.
I just don't know if I can do it.
I don't know.
Oh, Mallory, you're going to be great.
Oh, no, Angie, I'm scared. Them people out there, they're not going to love me. I don't know if I can do it.
And she was just so camera shy. Mm-hmm.
Camera shy.
I don't know how she made it through.
Get on the TV in the morning.
Let's look at what she did.
Yeah, so Mallory, this is for you. A little outtake of Mallory. Watch this.
Evan went out there. You know, I'm the hard worker working from home. All the moms and dads today at home.
Shout out.
I'm here to represent you, okay? Justin May said we're sitting and whining. We ain't. We're not sitting.
She did not like that last
week. I was sitting keeping the kids late at night so that Evan could go to the honk applause.
And I appreciate it.
And tell him what Justin did, what he thought you were doing.
So I'm standing out directing people where to park, and Justin says, hey, hold a sign so they don't think you're protesting. I'm standing out there with two glow sticks, and he thought I was going to be an angry protester at 10 o'clock at night.
Which makes me laugh because Evan protesting at 11 o'clock at night is not the time slot he would have chosen.
Definitely not. Always been a morning person.
But and tell him the other part.
One of the police officers came out and I told her he wanted to take a selfie with us. Three times.
He said three times. So police officer, if you're watching, please post it and tag at Evan Semenko because he felt so honored you wanted to take a selfie with
him. Me and Caleb, we're out there on the street. He just wanted to say thank you.
There you go. And I'll throw Christy A under the bus for just a minute because she made a cute little video and specifically said, moms, take them with you. Don't leave them at home. And I almost had a panic attack because Nora, we hadn't taken her to a store yet.
She hadn't been in public for 2 months.
And Eliza, I know you're listening, but you get crunk, girl. I can't trust them out there.
They don't wear masks.
I work the hardest out of everyone. Definitely. My boss is over my left shoulder in front of me, but
back.
I'm back.
I'm back
by popular demand.
I don't know about that. We'll see. Let us know in the comments.
I've prepared a roast for him. Brian, I asked you not to go too far away. He's in the background. Okay, back to me. Number three.
Oh, back to the clearing of grievances.
When I was doing, as I usually do, and walk into the office and tell you, good morning, how are you? What you up to, BR? Did you once reply to me that you were reading a podcast?
True or false?
True or false?
True. That is a true statement. Because I know the first 30 minutes is fluff. It's woo-ha.
Okay. Put that woo-ha. Camera back on me. Next. We know that a podcast is for listening. That's why they invented it. I also could insert something about Justin, but it's not his time to be roasted. But he asked us about a podcast. Remind me to bring that up again later.
We can roast Brian.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, hold on a second.
Evan, your wife...
Go to table of tech. Roll the little intro. Get him in. Come on, son.
Evan.
Get to it. There he is. Get his music going. Get him ready.
Back over here.
Let's have a chance to respond.
Thank you.
Come back to it.
Let me say one more thing.
Because Mallory's watching.
That woman... is not insecure or camera shy at all.
Camera back on me.
And I think I counted one. Okay, see, Justin, she roasted. Brian, she roasted. Christy threw under the bus. And you.
She's just on a mission, son. What was she doing? What's going on out there, Mallory? Get on the old Facebook and talk about it now. Are you wrangling the kids this morning? Come on, girl.
10 years in, I still don't know what she's doing some days. I don't know if I have an answer for that.
I understand.
So, Evan, how'd you feel about this past couple Sundays? What'd you think?
Man, I thought it went great. I thought it was fun. We missed y'all, but I thought Mallory did a great job. She was nervous the whole time. She turns that switch on. Oh, yeah. But she gets on there, and she just blacks out. She said, I don't even remember what I said.
I understand
that. It was awesome. It really was. I watched it from the beach, all cuddled up in my bed, my PJs, like the rest of the world usually
does. Yeah, go PJ church.
It was awesome. I loved it.
And I'm going to be honest with you. I didn't watch any of it. How about that? I'm like the rest of y'all out there.
He was like, peace out.
I said, Angie said, I'm watching the morning show. I said, and I'm watching the beach, son. That's what I'm doing.
That's what we paid to go there for, huh?
Yeah, hold on. We don't want to go there yet.
I wash my eyelids a lot on vacation.
Listen, we don't want to go there. Evan, but I got one issue with you real
fast. All right,
fast.
I'm ready.
Oh, gosh.
You started bringing up the protesters or whatever. You were standing out in the dark, all right? You
may have had glow sticks. It's like a raven.
It wasn't in a rain. I mean, you're in downtown Shreveport at 11 o'clock at night. I was like, hey, man, you might want to.
It was still dark. I don't know how they saw the sign.
Well, I don't know. I just got nervous. I was just glad you were down there. And Mallory, thanks for taking care of the kids.
Thank you. She does a great job. Nora and Eliza watch right now with her. We love you, Nora.
Come on. We love you, Nora Eliza. We got a great mom.
Goodness.
We did a great
job. We found a couple of those for Lisa McDaniel while y'all were out just to make sure she got
her. Yeah, they all. And then you had Chip's face every time we did it. But that's all right. We're glad to be back, and we're glad that you're watching. And Evan, is anybody on Facebook saying anything?
We got some folks on Facebook. Teresa Hagler's always there watching, said, there you go. There you go. You're fired up about it. She's back at school. Blake Lawson said, Mallory's scared. She's not going to say nothing. So Blake calling you out. Mallory's not coming on Facebook.
Oh,
I'm not sure.
Yeah, no, she's like mortified.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And then Jason St. Germain started a watch party. So if you're on Facebook, you can do a watch party and invite people to watch with you.
Oh, that's
have your
cool.
own private chat room. So Jason was in our life group. Thanks for doing that, Jason.
Yeah, Jason, great job. Come on, son. Getting it going.
Very good.
Got to keep telling people about it because I know how it is. You're trying to get back in the flow and some people on vacation.
School's starting back.
Yeah, school's starting back. So thank you for starting watch parties or whatever you're doing to try to get people watching us. Awesome.
Yep.
All right. So, Evan, give it over to Mallory.
Y'all did so good.
Mallory, good job, y'all. Thank
we
y'all for covering
Mallory.
For us while we're gone. So, it was awesome. See, they're making it happen, Angie. This next generation stepping up to the podium to make it happen. And it was so funny, though. She was acting like she was going to be scared to death. She was not scared to death.
No, I was scared to death when I did it the first time.
Yeah. But now you're in the zone. But let's go back to this beach zone since we talked about that real fast. Before we go into it, we're fixing to see a virtual lobby recap of all these people who've submitted some great things. And there's going to be one from Hawaii, which is awesome. Just all these great moments.
Yes.
But you just brought up, how much money did we spend on this vacation? Let's talk it out. This is post-show particularly, but today is pre-show because I'm still bitter, Angie.
Look, I did what I wanted to do on vacation.
Listen, we go down to wherever we're going, the beach, however it is, all right? We got no, you know, we're tight on the old money. I don't know if y'all know it, but COVID's put a hit on everybody. So we get down with the family, and guess who is the only one who goes to the beach? That would be the brown one here that had to put extra Mamaw powder on my head to keep you from reflecting into your living room and blinding you. And she is laid up in the bed. I said, are you ever coming to the beach? I just want to do what I want to do.
And I did what I wanted
and
to do.
And two teenagers did it, and Emma was my only one that would come out there, thank you, dooters, taking care of me.
She did. That's good. I'm glad y'all could walk the beach together because I enjoyed all my naps.
Yes, there was a lot of them. So, speaking of all that, if you're on vacation right now, school's starting in a couple of days, maybe a few days away from it. But reminder, send us some virtual lobby stuff of you and your kids getting ready for school or whatever for next week because this is the first week of school. So we'd love to have virtual lobby submissions based on you getting your kids ready for school or virtually, whatever you're going to do. It'd be kind of fun for next
week.
It'd
be super fun.
But here is a little recap of this past summer and all of the virtual lobbies that have come in. So check this out.
I got to find my way back.
Aloha. Hey, Simple Church.
Church.
We love and we miss you guys. We're coming at you from Oahu, Hawaii, on the Marine Base. And we've enjoyed all the online series. Got to give a shout out to our Simple Kids that we used to help out with. Hey, Christy, Elizabeth.
What's up? What's up, Justin? What's up, Chip? We miss you guys. Please keep the online ministry stuff coming.
Hey, Simple Church, it's the Burns family. We're coming at you this week from Granby, Colorado in the Rocky Mountain National Park. Hope y'all have a great Sunday.
This pre-show is the highlight of my week. I can hardly wait. Go, Angie. Crap, there was a horn in the background. Dang it.
Good morning, Simple Church. I hope y'all have a blessed, blessed Sunday.
Good morning, Simple Church.
Good morning, Simple Church.
Good morning, Simple Church.
We're here watching from
Ottawa,
Tennessee.
Good morning, Simple Church, from the Moss family. Hope you can join us at Shane's on East Texas Street for watch party. Hope you enjoy the service. Peace.
Good morning, Simple Church. We're from 16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama right now. Y'all have a great day. Love you.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about, man. Just a little recap.
I love to see all those little faces, especially those little baby faces.
How about Kelly getting a room ready for teaching? I'm just telling you. Oh, man, teachers. Man. We're going to get into that in the message today. I'm going to be talking a little bit about all that stuff today. But I just want to give a shout-out to all those teachers getting ready this week. I hope you had a good little summer, but now we know it's getting back to it, man. You got to make it happen. Yep. And to the parents, it's school, but it's school different. All right.
School is different.
Right. But what we've been trying to help them with is what we're doing in the Simple Church, giving them a little options on how they can watch and different things going on. Mm-hmm. So give me a little bit about what Christie is going to do, Angie. What's she done for us?
Christie has done a fabulous job for our kids, our Simple kids. So anytime we're doing our watch parties, Christie has a full service that your kids can watch.
Yep.
Simple Kids TV.
That's right. SK, here we go. So here it is. Christie, tell us about it, girl. Watch this. Little light up.
Hey, Simple Kids and parents, it's so great to see you. I just wanted to remind you that we have our own YouTube channel. We want you to subscribe so that every week you'll get a new episode. We don't want you to miss a single one. Every week we teach you a new Bible story. We love to worship together and learn a new life app. You'll get to see all of your favorite Clubhouse kids. If you don't have YouTube, that's okay. We have the Simple Church app. All you have to do is open the app and then scroll up and you'll see Watch Simple Kids TV here. It's that easy. So here's a sneak peek of what you'll see this week.
Hey kids, it's Mr. Pretzel. How are you?
Oh my gosh, today we're learning about creativity, which is like my middle name. I mean, look at how creative I am and everything in life. But it's not always about me, as you know. But check this out today, because creativity is awesome and you can find out what I want to be when I grow up and maybe even see more of this.
Don't forget, follow us on Instagram and Facebook so that you can stay connected with Simple Kids all week long. I hope you have a great week and I'll see you again soon.
See, this is what's cool about the Simple Church, trying to come up with creative ways to help you and your family. So we were picking with Mallory, having a little fun with it. We know it's not easy, seriously. It's very difficult.
No, it is hard when you got little babies at home, trying to keep everything organized.
Yeah, so that's why we love what the SK team has put together, which you're able to watch. You can go to the YouTube page, again, that you can watch Simple Kids at home. You can set them up. And it doesn't have to be right now in the morning. Some of you may be up fixing breakfast, trying to get things back on a routine. That's a great time to do it, but it might be other people are saying, man, I need to watch that in the afternoon. Give them a little something before they go take their nap time or whatever. But it is available for you. But it's not just TV. It is also incredible new ideas like this. FX in a box.
This is so awesome. I love this so much.
This is going to be a lot of fun. Now, we're going to start a new series next week. It's called Family 2.0. But this week, I'm even talking about it in the message coming up, FX in a box and what that is all about. An amazing creative idea to help you engage with your kids, not just through video content, but now through actual interaction at your table. You know what I'm saying? Having a little object lessons, some fun activities to do. And we're going to tell you a whole lot more about that. But to be honest, it'd be better if Christie told you a little bit more about it, because she's the woman, man, making it all happen. She has an amazing team. There's no doubt about it. But her vision is awesome. And so let's find out about the FX in a box and why you need to be picking one up today.
Today.
I'll tell you more about that in a minute. Christie, take it away.
Hey, Simple Church, I know that Justin updated you and let you know that we are not going to meet together in large groups until we get to phase 3. So the next question is,
what does that mean for our families? I'm excited to let you know that we've been taking this time to reevaluate things. We've been talking to our parents, to our families, and asking them, how can we partner better with you? And we've been listening. We know that it's difficult for families to get to church every Sunday morning with your kids. We know that it's even hard to watch service at home with your kids. We know you're tired, you're exhausted, and you're pulled in a bunch of different directions. But we also know that Simple Church has some of the best families around. And we know that you want to invest in your child spiritually and you want to connect with them on that level. But maybe you're just not sure how. So we want to help you. I'm excited to let you know that the Simple Church has created a new resource called Family Experience. We're going to call it FX for short. And FX is really designed to create meaningful experiences with your kids, even your grandkids, at home. We're so excited about this new resource. We know that you are going to love it. FX has several components. One, we're going to have FX Live, which will be a worship service created for families, for grandparents, for kids, for students, all to come together when we get back to phase three. But until that happens, we have this great new resource that we are launching very soon, and it's called FX in the Box, which really just means a family experience in the box. Inside each box, there are four different elements. The first element that's in every box is a quick object lesson. It's simply a devotion for you to do with your kids and your families at your own time. The next component in the box is a do-good project opportunity. We always teach you to love God and to love others. And how amazing is it when you get to have the opportunity to serve with your kids and to love others together? Another element is a family widget, which this is just something you'll lay on the counter to remind you every time you walk by of the box and the theme so that you'll remember to pay attention to your FX in the box. And finally, a fun element is included in each box, and we would not be Simple Church if we did not have something fun for you to do and experience together as a family. Each month, you'll have the opportunity to subscribe to an FX in the box. Each month will be a different theme, so please don't miss a single box. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you don't miss when we pass out the first FX in the box. Families, we know it's tough right now. We just want to be here to help you. Justin's even started a new sermon series called Family 2.0. It's time for an upgrade. I mean, isn't everyone excited like me when it's time to upgrade your phone? I think it's even more exciting for us to be able to upgrade our families. So continue to partner with us. Continue to stay connected so that we can help you create lasting family experiences.
Come on. That's what I'm talking about, Christy, making it happen.
She is so creative and her team is awesome.
So the series is actually going to start next week. Now, the reason I did that, I was on vacation, so there may be a little confusion on that. I wanted to end playlist, and it actually still talks about family and some of the stuff we're talking about because that's just something I want to have a little fun with today before we get out of playlist. But Family 2.0 starts next week. But today, this is the main thing you got to remember. Man, this is the day to pick up the boxes.
Yep.
Because this afternoon from 4 to 6 p.m. at Party Central, we're going to be handing out these boxes free. And the reason it's so important to come today is because inside the box, for example, is a fun activity for you to make back-to-school cupcakes. And we put the ingredients inside the box for you. We have lunchbox notes so that when you're making your lunches for your kids, lunchbox notes, that stuff is in here. But this is the thing that's really important as well, and that is the do-good project component to it. So we're going to talk about backpacks and back-to-school supplies and all that kind of stuff. So now I'm going to throw it to Robin so she can explain why today is so important to pick up your box, because you can also help us do some good right here in the community. Robin, take it away.
Hey, Simple Church, we are ready to do good in August, and this month we are focusing on our local schools. We know leaders throughout our communities are making super hard decisions right now concerning what's best for our kids when it comes to schools. And we want to be there and walk alongside them and pray for them, number one. But number two, we want to make sure our kids are resourced with the very basic essentials for school. And this is where you can help. We just need basic school supplies. Check out this list. All we're looking for is wide-ruled notebook paper, pencils or pens, a spiral notebook, pocket folders with those all-important brads, and crayons or markers. It's that simple. Drop those items off at the Simple Church office, 601 Benton Road. If you don't want to get out and shop, that's okay. We have made it super simple for you to buy a backpack filled with all the supplies online. Look for the Backpack Love icon on our website, our app, our social media platforms. Click that. It'll take you right to the website where you can buy as many of those backpacks as you want. They'll be shipped directly to us, and we will get them to the schools and our communities so that kids are resourced with the supplies that they need this year to succeed. We can't thank you enough for how you guys continue to do good, to love God, to love people, and to solve problems right here in our community and around the world.
Hey, we're at 192 already, again, delivered to the office. So we're trying to get 500 backpacks. So good job, man. 192. Make
fabulous.
It happen.
These here's just a couple of examples. Look at this little cute girl one.
Looking
little
good. Boy. Then I got the man one, too, son. Got a little red in it. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So tell me a little bit more about how it combines, man. Well, how are we working Do Good Projects and the FX Box?
Okay, well, inside our FX Box, there's a Do Good Family Challenge.
Yep.
And Chrissy's got a little bit of video so she can tell us what the Do Good Family Challenge is. Let's check that out.
Yep, check it out. This little light up. My eyes.
Welcome to the School Supply Family Do Good Challenge. Here's what we want you to do. You want to have some fun with your family? Get ready. We want you to take your family and divide your family into two teams. That's right, two teams. You're going to compete against each other. That's fun, right? So each team is going to have a list of five school supplies. You're going to put your mask on, then you're going to go in the store, and you're going to get those five school supplies. The first team that gathers all five school supplies first and brings it back to a member of the family is the winner. That's right. Let's see who can win. Are you ready to do this? Okay, I have our first family that's ready to do this challenge. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Here we go.
Kids, Angie, making it happen.
The first,
knocking it out of the park.
family.
Dude, that's awesome, yeah, man. And listen.
Well, they did it.
Yeah, you
and
can
said,
do it.
And he said subscribe.
He wants to make sure on the video you subscribe so you know what's going on. But this is why we're trying to get all these school supplies to all those great schools that are starting this week. And again, we cannot do it without your help. So it's also involved in this box. That is a family activity. It's not just, again, if you don't have a kid, you can do it without that. That's why we're trying to say that.
Yes.
But if you have a kid, please come pick up the box today from 4 to 6 p.m. at Party Central. And breaking news. Go ahead. What you got?
I was going to say, I heard somebody's going to be there.
Spud. Yes, that's what I was going to say. It's breaking news.
I thought
news.
You might have been bringing that up.
A Spud's coming, man.
Spud, ice cream man.
Yep, and well, staff will be out there. We'd love to see all of you guys. Yes. Just encourage you and remind you. The boxes are free. And if you are watching in another part of the world, all right, here's the good news. We have a website that's been created for this as well, the FX Experience. It is the FX. Is that right? .tv, all right, the FX, T-H-E, like The Simple Church, it's thefx.tv, and you can have them mailed to your house. It's on our Simple Church website as well, and the app. So if you download the app, you go to the website, you can get all that stuff sent to you. It's just pretty fun, man, because it's a great way to involve your family in a great activity.
And who wouldn't love that delivered to the doorstep?
And I'm going to tell you why this is going to be so important when we're moving into the next series, because we really believe this is a key time to implement some change, and we need your help doing that. And it's going to be pretty fun. It's going to be awesome. All right, speaking of change and awesome, we were also trying to help out our friends over in Lebanon. We only got a couple of minutes. I'll tell you more about that in the post show because we ain't got time to get into that.
Time.
But please go to our website, look into all that because we're trying to raise a little money. Need about $10,000 to help those people that have been devastated. By, again, an unbelievable tragedy. So just make sure you remember we are trying to help them over there. But I got to get into something else, Angie. All this is good. They've done an amazing job and all this stuff.
I don't know where he's going.
Yeah, well, because, no, you don't know, but you will remember. I think this is a picture that just kind of explains it best. Yeah, go ahead and put up. This is colonoscopy, Angie.
Oh,
have you ever seen something like that right there? You're doing it wrong. Angie had a colonoscopy this week. Now, the reason I'm saying that is we had a sweet nurse. One of my friends, Doug Rimmer, went to Southwood. He was your doctor. So you had a sweet nurse. Her name was Charlie. So this is an official apology to Charlie right now because my Angie was so high and out of her mind. She was saying things that I've never in my wildest dreams thought she'd say. I actually videoed some of it, and guess what Angie told me?
No.
Over my dead body.
A girl's got to draw the line somewhere.
Yes. But I just wanted you to know that you embarrassed me, you embarrassed the church, you embarrassed your kids.
Justin Hagler.
Hey,
I did not. I said nice things to Charlie. I was just a little.
Hey, you want to know where the M&M came from that we were bringing in? Is when she woke up, they had to shake her to wake her up. She woke up and she said, guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess who's back? And I was like,
"Is this my wife?"
I think you were having wherever that colonoscopy took you, you were in a good place.
Yeah.
You said when you woke up, you said, "I know why Michael Jackson likes this."
I did.
He's dead, Angie. Michael Jackson's dead. You can't be playing around with all that. Oh my Lord! All right, look, we got to get started because the service is coming.
Thank you, Charlie, for taking care of me. I'm sorry if I was offensive in any way and talked way too loud, from what I understand.
We'll get more in the post show on that. All right, let me get back to it. All right, the reason I had to talk about the colonoscopy is because
I've been sick and you feel sorry for me.
That's in the list. We'll do more
it
in the post show.
All he wants to do is make fun of me. I've been sick.
She has been sick. Pray for her.
He doesn't
care. Put on the prayer list. I do care. All right, but it's all about prayer, Angie.
You put a skier slide across his butt on the water. That's real sorry for you, honey.
When I woke up this morning, I was like, how can we talk about it?
I was afraid it was going to be my drunk self.
I know. She did warn me. She said, I'm telling you, do not put me on that video. Angie, the people need to see it.
It was funny, though. It was hilarious.
The people need to see it. No, if they get on Facebook and start telling us they want to see it, I'm posting some of it next week.
We'll see, maybe.
Yeah, it's great stuff. But speaking of the service, we got to get into it because it's time to start. We went old school. The reason we had to do a little playlist, closure, wrap it up. Speaking of prayer, it's all about the message today.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Because we've been praying for you. People are praying for you. Honey, I'm praying for you. But this is about living on a prayer, Angie. I couldn't go out.
Mary, do you?
Amen. And this is why I heard Jordan laughing way off in the distance.
Because it's true.
I know, but I'm going to try
everybody
to. Everybody knows. All right, but I'm going to get into it because they pulled me out of retirement, Angie.
Uh-huh.
And I was nervous about it because the song is a high song.
Yes.
It's like, Living on a Prayer is next. Look, don't look at people texting
people
you.
Are texting
Quit
me
texting
already.
Angie during the pre-show. She can't handle it.
It's probably people feel sorry for me. Like, I'm sorry, Angie. We're praying for you.
So, without further ado, this is getting us, we're closing out playlist.
This is my sexy husband bringing it back.
Yeah. So
thanks for coming out of retirement, honey.
Well, you're being, see how sweet she is? Even when I throw on the bus, she's sweet. I love you.
You know, I love you too.
Best. So, here's, Justin is singing, Don't Judge Me on This. It's been a while coming out of retirement, but the band killed it. You guys are awesome, and I was honored to be on stage with
Unbelievable.
You. Here's a little Bon Jovi wrapping up playlist with a little Living on a Prayer. Watch this.